Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how to create a user interface using Java and Visual Studio Code. So first we need to check that the Java JDK is installed correctly. So let's open the command prompt and let's type java --version. So here we can see that the Java JDK is installed correctly. Now let's close this window and let's go to Visual Studio Code. So here we need to install a new extension called Java Extension Pack. So let's click on this button and here let's type Java Extension Pack. Let's select this first extension. So it is from Microsoft and we need to install it. So let's click on this install button. Now the extension is installed correctly. So let's close this page and also we can hide the extensions. Let's click on this button and now we need to create a new Java project. So let's click on create a Java project and let's select no build tools. Then let's select the folder that will contain our project. So I will create a new folder on the desktop and I will call it Java projects. Now let's click on select the project location and now let's create a folder for the new project. So I will call it first project. Let's hit enter. Now the project has been created and by default it contains one class and the source folder which is called app. Let's create a new class into this folder. So let's make a right click on the folder, then new file. So I will create a new file called mainframe.java. Let's hit enter. So this file has been created and it contains this class. Now I want to convert this class into a JFrame. So let's add extends JFrame. So here we have an error because we need to import this class. To fix this error we can click on quick fix. Then import JFrame. So this line has been added and the error disappeared. We can remove the class name and add star to import all the classes of this package. Now let's create the method that will initialize the frame. So I will create a new method called initialize. Now let's add the statements that allow us to initialize the frame. So first I will set a title to this frame. Also I will set a size. And I will set a minimum size to this frame. Also, when I click on the close button of the frame, I want the application to be stopped. And finally, I will make this frame visible. But here I have an error because I need to import this class. So let's click on quick fix, then import. Now the import has been added and the error disappeared. We can remove the class name and replace it with star to import all the classes of this package. Now let's create the main panel of this frame. So I will create a new JPanel called main panel. Then let's set the layout manager of this panel. So I will use a border layout as the layout manager. Now let's take a look on the appearance of the interface when using a border layout. So a border layout divides the interface into 5 areas: the north, the south, the center, the east, and the west. But in our case, we only need the north part to create the form, the center part to create the welcome label, and the south part to create 2 buttons. Now let's set the background color of the main panel. Now let's create the panel that will be located in the north of the main panel. So the panel that will be created in the north of the main panel is called the form panel and it contains our form. So first let's add a label. Then let's set the font of this label. So let's create a global variable called main font. And let's use it as the font of this label. Now let's create a new text field and let's create it as a global variable. Let's call it TF like text field first name. And let's initialize it just here. Then let's set the font of this text field. Now let's create a new label and let's set its font. Now let's create a new text field and let's create it as a global variable. So I will just declare it here and I will call it TF last name. Now let's initialize this text field and let's set its font. Now let's create the form panel that will contain these components. And let's set the layout manager of this panel. So I will use a grid layout containing 4 rows and 1 single column. And these are the margin between the different components. Now let's add the different components to this form panel. Now let's add this form panel to the main panel. So I will add the form panel in the north of this main panel. Now let's create the welcome label. So I will create a new label that is a global variable. So I will just declare it here. Let's call it LB welcome. Then let's initialize it here. We can also set the font of this label. Now let's add this label to the center of our main panel. Now let's create the two buttons that we will add to the bottom of our interface. So I will create a button called BTN OK and I will write the text OK on this button. And then I will set the font of this button. Now let's add a listener to this button. Now we need to import this class, so let's click on Quick Fix. And let's click on Import Action Listener. Then we need to implement the method of this interface. So let's click on Quick Fix. Then add unimplemented methods. So this method will be executed when we click on the OK button. What I want to do here is to read the text of the two text fields and to display it in the welcome label. So let's do this. Now let's create the second button. So this button is called BTN Clear and it contains the text clear. Also, I will set the font of this button. Now let's add a listener to this button. Now let's implement the method of this interface. So let's click on Quick Fix and let's click on Add Unimplemented Methods. So this method will be executed when we click on the clear button. What I want to do here is to make the text fields and the welcome label empty. So let's do this. Now let's create the panel that will contain the two buttons. Then let's set the layout manager of this panel. So I will use a grid layout containing 1 single row and 2 columns. And these are the margins between the different components. Now let's add the two buttons. And let's add this panel to the main panel. And of course I will add this panel to the south of the main panel. Now let's add the main panel to the G-frame. So to be able to execute this class, we need to create the main method. Then let's create an object of type mainframe. And let's call the initialize method of this object. Now let's save this file and let's run it. So we can click on this run button. And we obtain this interface. It is possible to improve this interface by adding a margin to the main panel. Also, we can make the form panel transparent, and also we can make the buttons panel transparent. So let's do this. First, let's add the margin to the main panel. Then let's make the form panel transparent. So let's call the method setOpaque false. Now let's make the buttons panel transparent. Now let's save the file and let's run the application. And this is the obtained interface. We can increase its width. And we can see that it has a minimum width. Also, we can modify its height. And we can see that it has a minimum height. Now let's write some text. For example, let's write Bill Gates. And let's click on OK. And we obtain this text. Let's click on Clear. And all the fields are now clear. If I click on this Close button, the application will be stopped. Finally, thank you very much for watching and please subscribe to the channel.